When I say the words terminal illness, what do you think of? Oh, unfortunately, the word that comes to my mind is death. In 2019, 121,500 deaths were recorded due to Alzheimer's disease. But what if this disease could be reversed? And what if stem cells were the answer? While diseases like Alzheimer's are devastating, I can't help but wonder how these neurodegenerative diseases manifest in one's brain and why scientists have yet to find a cure for them. I remember when I was younger, I had a conversation with my parents, and they told me that when my brother and I were born, stem cells were taken from my mother's umbilical cord and stored in a cell bank. Naturally, I was confused, so I asked, why? They said that stem cells were being used for neurodegenerative diseases such as Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, and Huntington's disease, just to name a few, and that these cells would be useful for me later in life. I was so amazed at this concept that a part of me could be used to heal myself from possible diseases I may acquire in the future. These minuscule cells furthered my love for science and medicine, and I became more interested in learning about the foundation of life itself. Cells, or in this case, stem cells. Stem cells have the unique ability to develop into practically any cell within the body. But before I explain the nitty-gritty, let me first tell you how stem cells really came to my attention. So after that conversation with my parents, I didn't put too much thought into stem cells or the fact that I had some stored in a cell bank for quite some time. But my amazement with these cells started up again when I gained a newfound interest in dementia and the influence it had on people's lives and the effect it had on their brains. I started to research Alzheimer's, which is a form of dementia, as dementia is just the umbrella term for several diseases affecting cognitive function. And I came across the term stem cells more frequently. But at that time, I didn't know much about the topic other than what my parents told me about the advances being made in medicine using stem cell application. Now, if you want to have a basic understanding of stem cells, you have to understand basic human development, as it begins with pregnancy, which happens after a sperm cell fuses with a woman's egg, which then develops into a zygote and then a blastocyst. And this is where the magic happens. A blastocyst is a cluster of dividing cells made by a fertilized egg roughly 5 days after fertilization. This is where the enormous surplus of embryonic stem cells are located, and it is at this stage in particular where these pluripotent stem cells show the most promise. And I know, most of you are probably thinking, Valentina, you can't be throwing words like embryonic stem cells and pluripotent around with no explanation, but don't worry, I got you. So any person that begins to research stem cells will naturally become overwhelmed by the many components and groups that seem to overlap somehow, because I know I was. So let's start with the word pluripotent. Pluripotent was a term I often encountered, and I was under the impression that it was this big group of stem cells with smaller groups, and within one of those groups being embryonic stem cells. But this is not the case. The word pluripotent actually means many potentials. So in other words, these cells have the potential to develop into any cell within the body. So embryonic stem cells are pluripotent. You can think of these cells as like the roots of a tree. Just as tree roots give rise to different branches and leaves, pluripotent stem cells have the ability to differentiate into various cell types within the body, forming the branches and trees of the body's tissues and organs. Now, adult stem cells are another type of stem cell group, typically found in developed tissue throughout the body. You can find them in the brain, skin, heart, liver, and bone marrow. And these cells typically have the job of repairing dead or damaged tissue throughout our body. And these are the cells that heal cuts on our skin, for example. They're also referred to as somatic stem cells because they're non-reproductive and they also typically scarce, which makes them challenging to study. They're also multipotent, which means they do have the ability to develop into more than one cell type, but means they just have a more limited ability than pluripotent stem cells. Now, iPSCs, or induced pluripotent stem cells, are another type of stem cell group made by reprogramming adult stem cells. This process includes introducing a set of factors, such as dermal fibroblasts, which are cells that help heal the skin from injury. These cells are then genetically reprogrammed to an embryonic stem cell-like state, or a state of pluripotency. iPSCs show much promise in being used in personalized medicine due to their ability to develop into more than one cell type when programmed to do so. Now, the last type of stem cell group I want to share with you all today are MSCs, or mesenchymal stem cells. MSCs are adult stem cells commonly found in the bone marrow and umbilical cord. And these are actually the cells that my brother and I have stored in a cell bank. Despite being found in the umbilical cord, MSCs are classified as adult stem cells solely based on property and function rather than tissue origin, also meaning that they are multipotent. Stem cells are being used in ways people 50 years ago would have believed to be science fiction, but they still have a long way to go. The field that stem cells are being used in today is called regenerative medicine, and it's centered around implementing and creating new treatments to aid the body in naturally healing and repairing tissue and replacing lost functionality brought on by aging, illness, injury, or defect. Adult stem cells show much potential from being able to be used to treat type 1 diabetes, in which they would provide insulin-producing stem cells, and cardiac cells to replace damaged cardiac muscle after a heart attack, to neurological diseases, in which they would regenerate lost neurons in the brain or spinal cord. In a study done by Stanford's Dr. Marcus Wernig, stem cells were found to reduce brain abnormalities typical of Alzheimer's in mice. This is actually a really good indicator that it will be promising in humans, as mice have a similar anatomy. Stem cells have also begun to be tested in sports medicine regarding the treatment of damaged tendons, torn ligaments, and other muscle and bone injuries. To put it into perspective, imagine you are a great athlete who tears their ACL. Typical surgery would mean a long recovery process and uncertainty about your future career. But with stem cell therapy, the damaged area would be injected with stem cells, leading to a shorter and less invasive recovery process. So, what does this mean for our future and the future of regenerative medicine? And mesenchymal stem cells are also being used as an extensive tool for diseases such as stroke and Alzheimer's. But the reason that there's no cure for these diseases yet is that stem cell therapy will only replace damaged cells, but not cure the genetic root cause that most of these neurodegenerative diseases typically arise from. So what does this mean for our future and the future of regenerative medicine? Well, firstly, let's celebrate an already successful treatment used in medicine today, which is a blood stem cell transplantation typically used for cancer patients to replace dead and damaged cells within the body. And back in 2018, Japanese scientists conducted a clinical study where they used neurological material derived from iPSCs to treat Parkinson's disease. And while the results were very promising, this treatment is years from clinical use. I believe that the future of stem cell therapies will transform disease outcomes for many patients and lead to many more groundbreaking scientific discoveries. And it's why scientists and doctors should continue to advocate for the importance of stem cell research. Because as this amazing area of medicine continues to expand, I urge you to support stem cell research by donating to stem cell initiatives that work hard to advance this area of medicine and share their findings while doing so. And as you walk out of here today, I want you to think about how stem cell research is reshaping modern medicine as we know it, and is changing lives and could one day change yours too.